Dear students, now we will be discussing about learners with other disabilities. So this is your last unit, unit number 4. So the objectives of this unit are to identify the learners with locomotor impairment, cerebral palsy, autism spectrum conditions, and multiple disabilities. Secondly, to discuss how to assess their performance in school and to identify difficulties with respect to their learning characteristics. Lastly, to explain the specific strategies to meet out their needs. So, learners with locomotor disabilities. So, a person's inability to execute distinctive activities associated with moving both personally and objects from place to place, and such inability resulting from afflictions of musculoskeletal and or nervous system has been defined as locomotor disability. Now coming to the assessment of learners with locomotor disabilities. First is any deviation or delay in a child's developmental milestones. Secondly, excessive stiffness or floppiness of child. Use of limbs of only one side of the body. Difficulty or abnormality observed when the person is asked to do the following. First is to lift arm overhead. Second is pick a small object lying in front of him or her. Third is pick a stone from the ground. Fourth one is walk a few steps. And fifth and last is run a short distance. Other features are difficulty in standing up from the sitting position, range of motion of joint decreased or excessively increased, absence of limb in part or full. Use of appliances, for example, sticks, crutches, wheelchairs, and tricycle. In addition, early detection of locomotor disabling disease based on early biochemical, morphological, and functional changes that precede the occurrence of manifest signs and symptoms is of particular importance in chronic diseases. Coming to the supporting of learners with locomotor disabilities in classroom or school. The school needs to be made barrier-free. Classrooms should be located on the ground floor so that children can align from the school bus and reach their classrooms with minimum of difficulty. If that is not feasible, the school should have ample elevator service and or inclined ramps, especially for children who use wheelchairs for their mobility. The school should have ramps, elevators, handrails, larger toilet cubicles, adequate wide paths, doors, entrances, etc., specially designed desks and chairs to accommodate all. In addition to a special teacher, one or more attendants should be provided to help those needing additional assistance. In addition to specially designed classrooms, specially designed instructional equipment should be provided. So that's all in this particular video. Thank you very much.